at the risk of this being windy, sorry about that, it's a bright, breezy May morning on the Isle of Wight, and I'm on a boat, not a train for the day. As we're heading, it's literally just over there, to the Wight Shipyard Company in Cowes, on the Isle of Wight, where they're building the new Thames Clippers. So yeah, we're at the Wight Shipyard Company, that big sign up there. We're going inside where the new Thames Clippers boats are being built. And there's an interesting twist to them. They're much greener than any other boat that Thames Clippers have used before, because they're going to be hybrid. Let's find out why.
Yes, these are the new Hunt class Clippers, which are being designed and built here at the Wight Shipyard. And they invited us down for a look around, see them being built, and ask some questions.
What you want to know is how many existing Thames Clippers there are and how many they're being built, right? Which is why this person here, Maddie, is going to tell us.
Hi, Maddie.
How many existing Thames Clippers are there?
There are 21 in the current fleet, and two are currently being built here at Wight Shipyard.
Now, is it two or is it three? There's an option for a third, is that
two
right?
Two currently, but there's an option for a third, yeah.
Okay. But the thing about them is that they're not just diesel, are they? They're going to be battery hybrid as well, which is a first?
First UK hybrid passenger ferry, yeah.
Are we going to go for a walk around? We're going to get to have an explore, right?
We are, yes.
Let's have a look around. We're having a brief discussion about what to call this, because I wanted to call it a shed, or is it a shipyard, or a ship hall? We might go with building hall. We found out that this hangar was built as a hangar. Seaplanes were once built here, and now they're building boats here. Apparently we can climb inside. Just casually walking inside the hull of one of the new Thames Clippers. Like you do.
Obviously the big thing here is that these are going to be hybrid, so they're going to be diesel engines but with battery motors, or how does the battery part work?
So effectively they're going to be HVO fueled engines, man engines, that will at high speed, up to 30 knots, be delivering both power to the jets but equally power to the battery as well. So that when we reduce our speed, in particularly throughout our central zone in London, so that's just below Tower Bridge, up to Battersea Power Station, they'll be operating purely on battery.
HVO, by the way, stands for hydro-treated vegetable oil. A very clean diesel. Let's go Google HVO, I'll put it on screen. HVO, I had to ask what it meant, I didn't know what it meant. Yes, you might not have known this. What Sean was saying is that as boats, Thames Clippers, come from the east into the centre of London, the central bit of the Thames, on the approach to Tower Bridge, about 3/4 mile out, there's a maximum speed limit, and all boats have to slow down from 30 knots to around sort of 8 to 12 knots. That's why boats go a lot slower right in the heart, sort of zone one of the Thames, than they do than when they're out east. It's all aluminium build, by the way. This is clearly aluminium, but what they're doing, so much cutting and chopping, and there's like this fine aluminium dust residue, which is getting all over my hands, all over my camera, probably in my hair. I'm not going gray, that's aluminium dust in my hair, and I'm sticking to that.
Yeah, so at the moment we've got one of our guys here just knocking up some bits for a superstructure that we've got going on. And obviously we've got the clippers over there.
I mean, there's a lot of arc welding going on.
Yes.
Is anything screwed together with nuts and bolts anymore, or is it just...
Yeah,
just,
absolutely.
Just all welded?
Absolutely. At this stage, it's all about welding and fabrication, the whole construction phase. But later on, when we're putting in engines and other systems, then a lot of nuts and bolts come out then. So these are the foundations for the electric motors on the clippers. Obviously, where these are hybrid boats, we need an electric motor on board, so that's what these are.
Keep having Shipbuilding by Elvis Costello. Gonna have that in my head all day now. Great. You always hear this great phrase bandied around, which is net zero.
Yeah.
We can't get there in one leap, can we?
No, we can't. I mean, it's a bit like, you know, buses. You can get a bus in the inner city London, which is fully electric, but you can't get a bus that goes from London to Edinburgh that's electric. And it's the same with ships and ferries. If you've got short distance at low speed, it can be electric. If it's not, it has to be done in steps. And it'll come, but you know, we're not going to go from smelly old diesel engines to zero emissions overnight or even within a few years. It has to be gradual. And these are the first step where, when they're in the city of London, they'll be zero emissions, but outside they'll be onto conventional diesels, which will be much, much, much cleaner than the old ones.
Peter was just saying, all this aluminium lying around, it's very green. If you've got a boat that's made of fiberglass and it comes to the end of its life expired, you have to bury that boat in the ground or let it sink in the river. Aluminium, however, can be cut up and reused up to 8 times, so much better to make boats of aluminium. So that new boat takes about 8 months to build. It should be finished and delivered to Thames Clippers by October of 2023 and in service hopefully to about November of 2023. If you didn't know, by the way, for ages, Woolwich Arsenal was the last sort of, was the last river pier going out east on the Thames, but there's a new one, Barking Riverside, where there's a brand new London Overground station, of course, opening up in December of this year. There's a new river pier that's already running out there. It took like 1,000 passengers in its first week as well. But also, there's another new pier going out east. Even further than that, there's a really old iron pier, might be the oldest iron pier in Britain, out at Gravesend. It's called Town Pier, and that will also be added by 2024 to the Thames Clippers network. But at some point, you will be riding on that Thames Clippers' first diesel electric hybrid boat, ferry, ship. I'm just going to sing shipbuilding now. Thanks for watching. Press subscribe.